everyone. Hope you're having a great day. I was talking to somebody last week about a very special relationship that they have. And I thought about my own very special relationships this weekend in particular. And I realized that we as humans have a terrific way of taking something that is relatively insignificant and making it significant. The whole mountain out of a molehill scenario. And this is a really painful process for any relationship. And so I have a clue, I have a tip as to how you can get out of that tornado, because that's exactly what's happening. It's like this swirling vortex of hot air, and it forces us into this awful, almost like we're being flushed down a toilet. It's this awful cyclone of getting worse and worse and worse and worse and worse and more and more nitpicky and further away from the truth about each other. And we can embroil ourselves in this mess, this heartache between each other. And the more momentum we pick up in our argument, the more crap we're picking up, the more debris. If you think about a tornado, like in the movie Twister, the further it goes, the more crap it picks up, the more momentum, and the bigger and the bigger and the bigger, and the more destruction it makes. Well, that's like what an argument does to a relationship, and not just that relationship. It does it to the entire human family. And when I say family, you can even enlarge it to include friends, neighbors, coworkers. You know, it depends on the environment with which in which the argument started. But you do so much damage, and the more you allow an argument to continue, the longer you allow it to continue, the more damage it does, the more havoc it wreaks. So, and speaking of reeks, it totally reeks. So what we need to do as humans is remind ourselves of each other and of each other's worth. There's a reason why you got connected to that person in the first place. And probably when you were first with that person, you had impressions about them, those first impressions, that were most likely positive. And say you've got a coworker that you can't stand, okay? So maybe you've never had a positive first impression. Well, there has bound to be something good about that person. And the key to getting off of this awful tornado ride is to find the good and hold to it. You know how when people say to avoid getting dizzy? In something like a tornado with that kind of momentum, that you've got to fix your focus on one spot, fix your gaze on one spot, and stay there. And that prevents you from getting dizzy. Well, the same thing is true in completely unplugging the motivation and momentum behind a tornado. You must fix your gaze on the positive aspects of that other person and hold it in your thought, regardless of what's going on in front of you. So say they're being a complete jerk, but it's just in that moment. We all have times of being complete jerks, depending upon what our life is doing to us. And so we must have compassion for those around us and hold in our thought the one thing about them that is good and that is true, and forget the rest. And in that way, the tornado will wind down, your feet will fall back on the ground solid, and you and your relationship will be solid again, and the havoc wreaking will stop. And you will be whole, and your relationship will be whole again. And isn't that, in the end, what you're after, instead of being right or wrong? Much love to you and your trials. You can do this. You're better than that. We'll see you next time.